Hello, I am Dr. Nagaraj Puttaswamy, laparoscopic surgeon at Punya Hospitals, Bangalore. See, hepatitis is a condition, or it is an infective condition most often. See, we have different types of hepatitis, hepatitis A, B, C, all this. It's a little confusing for a common man to understand what is hepatitis A, hepatitis B and C and all that. But simple, I can easily tell you that there are two modes of transmission of hepatitis A, B or C. One is feco-oral contamination. That I mean to say that feces, what we pass. See, I'm a hepatitis A infected person. I have a heavy possibility that my fecal matter contains or carries this virus of hepatitis A. See, if I am a outdoor defecator, say I have the high possibility of the contaminating the field, or probably the water which drains into some feeding areas, I can probably infect people who drink that water. This is how the contamination or the transmission happens. Or say, for example, an infected person probably doesn't maintain good hygiene. Probably he is a hotel server or a cook or a chef, so probably he'll probably serve some food to a people or a customers who go to the hotel to have dinner or lunch. This is how the transmission of hepatitis A happens. On the contrary, hepatitis B and C are infective hepatitis, we call them as. They are transmitted in the form of say sexually transmitted disease, or they are transmitted following blood transfusion which is infected, or say for example, getting shaven by infected blade, which is not so very oftenly seen because we use disposable blades of late. These are the modes of transmission of hepatitis. But see, hepatitis A, hepatitis B and hepatitis C, all are medically managed conditions. None of them require a surgical intervention at all. Many a times hepatitis A is self-limiting disease. See, if the patient is managed well, because the patient may be in infective state in early stage. So what we have to do is just have to be in bland diet, manage the patient well, keep him well hydrated, high carbohydrate, low protein diet and fat diet, so patient gradually recovers because it's a viral infection. Similarly, hepatitis B, if it is a fulminant infective state, the patient may get into a very sick state where we call as a pre-hepatic coma, or a very difficult condition to manage in. So we don't want that patient to get into such shape or difficulty. We have to manage in advance by giving antiviral and general support to the patient. These patients usually carry the disease for a relatively longer period of time in the blood. So they become carriers for years together. See, they have a high tendency to transmit the disease from them to the people who get communicated closely to them. In the form, say for example, a patient who is a HbsAg positive, that is hepatitis B positive, can induce the disease into a surgeon who is operating, or a nurse or the staff who is treating the patient. This is how the transmission can happen, and there is nothing like a surgical intervention for any sort of hepatitis.